his reign from the length and breadth of Ghana. Let peace prevail. And I'm talking about the peace of God that passes all understanding. Because if you look at Philippians 4:6, he said, be careful for nothing. Don't be troubled and worry. Anxious for nothing about the speculations and the fears and the threatenings and the intimidations of men and women. He said, don't be worried about any of this. But he said, in all of this, with prayers, supplication, with intercession, giving of thanks, having an attitude of gratitude, even in the midst of the chaos, that God is able. He said, then shall the peace of God, which passes all understanding. If we would do these things, what things? If we will pray, if we will intercede, give thanks, supplication before God, then God said, I will guarantee peace. That I will give you peace, not as the world gives. I will give you peace that passes all understanding. Ladies and gentlemen, if there is any other way to obtain peace, the Bible would have told us. There's no other way to obtain peace but to pray. And if we pray to Almighty God, he that hears and answers prayer, I guarantee you, peace shall prevail within our walls. We need to pray that any outcome of 2020 election and any event within our election that will compromise our peace and will create any state of civil unrest to bring about any confusion and violence in this land, by the name that is above every other name, let that event be arrested. Let that event be arrested. And let anyone that the enemy has deployed to use as a weapon to bring about unrest to this country and to create about any kind of a situation of civil unrest, violence, shedding of innocent blood, in the name of the Lord Jesus, let such a one by the armies of heaven be redeployed. Mayandu kalimba du devaluki andamaha sanawala hakin sidi behaya. Let God arise. Let the God of the armies of heaven arise. And let the enemies of the peace and the destiny of this country be like chaff before the wind. Yea, let them be as smoke that is carried away. May they perish as wax melt before fire. But let God arise and let the voice of the God of the armies of heaven be heard in the outcome of 2020 election. Lastly, the Bible says that men cast their lot, but the Lord determines the outcome. I pray that as men go out, and we all go out, men and women, on the 7th of December, and cast and exercise our rights, that the counsel of Almighty God will determine the outcome of the election. For it is written, many are the desires or devices in the heart of a man, but the counsel of the Lord shall determine the outcome. Let the counsel of the Lord win the day. Let Ghana win. Let Ghana be priority. Let Ghana be first in 2020 election. Let no man and let no woman, let no sorcerer, let no diviner, let no warlock, let no deity, let no principality, let no beast, let no throne, let no dominion determine in the name of Jesus the destiny of this country, and let nothing compromise the peace and the safety of the destiny and the people of Ghana. Please stand.